Good morning. This is Sheshachalam from AstroGuide Mysore. So, continuing the planetary positions which are influencing the type of marital relationship, the type of marriage, or whether they give positive influence toward the marriage or the negative influence toward the marriage. Let me talk about the placement of Venus in the 7th house or influencing the 7th lord. So, here, when Venus is posited in good houses, what do you mean by good houses is when Venus is posited in its own house, in its friendly house, or in its house of exaltation, and that being the 7th house or the placement of Lagna itself, Venus will protect the marriage, it will give good marriage, and sometimes it might give early marriage. So most of the times, Venus being the karaka for marriage gives that the attraction from the native, attraction into the native towards the opposite gender. Like if it is sitting in the 7th house or with the 7th lord, it will influence the native towards getting attracted towards the opposite gender. Like a person will get attracted, and because of that attraction, he might make the first move of trying to propose. So, usually in charts where Venus is posited along with the 7th lord, either if the influence of the 5th house and the 9th house is not that strong, also the 2nd house, if that is not strong on the 7th house or vice versa, then this might end up into an arranged marriage, which actually might not be a love marriage at all, an early arranged marriage. But if there are some influences of the 2nd house, the 5th house, 2nd house being the Kutumbasthana, 5th house being the house of romance, and 9th house being the house of blessing, that is the parental blessing or the guardian's blessing towards marriage. So, if there is influence between these houses, then a romantic relationship getting converted to a marriage would be more a possibility. So, in this particular case, I'm only talking about benefic aspects of Venus as of now. So, if Venus is posited in either the point of exaltation, the point of, the own house, own sign, or with a very good friend in its friend's house, or in its friend's house. So, we call this Deeptamsha Mudita or Pramudita. These are the avastas, Deepta avastha, Mudita avastha, Pramudita avastha. These are the avastas where a planet gets a benefic influence. In cases of Lagna, where Venus is a negative planet by nature, like for example, for Vrishchika Lagna, Venus is considered a prime malefic. For Sagittarius Lagna, Venus is considered a prime malefic. Vrishchika being Scorpio, Sagittarius being Dhanur Rashi. So, for these two Lagnas, if Venus is not posited in good houses, like for example, for Dhanur Rashi, if Venus is posited in the 11th house in its own sign, it's a fantastic position for Venus. It will never influence the 7th house anyway because it doesn't aspect. But if Venus is posited in the 7th house for Sagittarius, or if Venus is posited in the 7th house for Scorpio, being a prime malefic, it should destabilize the marriage or give early relationships which might break without any reason, or some consequential reason might be there which might not be that important. But still, there is a hurdle. Which might try to cut off this relationship because Venus position in the 7th from Sagittarius or Scorpio is not that strong. Though from Scorpio, it gives Malavya Yoga. So though it is giving you a Pancha Mahapurusha Yoga, that is for many other things, but with regard to marriage, it might not be a stable marriage if there is a negative influence, a little bit of negative influence also. Okay. In certain cases, Venus, though being exalted, shows little bit of negativity when it is in the 7th house. That is for the Virgo ascendant. For Virgo, Venus being the second and the ninth lord is an excellent position in the seventh house. Usually turns up to be a love marriage. But in certain cases, it acts very weird. That's because Venus might be retrograde, or it might be very close to Sun. It might be combust, or it might be influenced by Rahu and Ketu in its axis. So if Venus is not bad, it's not influenced in a bad way, then there is no point of checking Venus whether it is giving any difficulty to the marriage. We have to check the seventh lord, that is Jupiter, which actually is a prime malefic for Virgo Lagna, being the Bhadaka Adipati, and also it acquires the Kendra Adipatya Dosha. So Venus in the seventh house usually gives a smooth, happy going, comfortable marriage, and but it is a little weak when compared to the stability of marriage. It all depends whether there is an influence of Saturn on the horoscope, that is a strong influence of the Saturn on the horoscope, that is whether Saturn is strong towards the Lagna and Jupiter is strong towards the Lagna, which actually gives responsibility and duty to the person, Saturn and Jupiter. So if a responsible person anyhow will not go in for any sort of panic or any sort of impulsive anxious decisions or unnecessary reactions. So Jupiter and Saturn in a horoscope is very important for us to check whether the marriage will stay stable. So anyway, now coming back to the point, Venus is a beautiful planet for married life and for early marriage, because it's a fast moving planet, and also it gives good marital happiness. Thank you.